time folds back on itself. Again, his senses scream as the very impossibility of what is happening assaults them. But the champion of light endures. Each time he gets a little closer, each time another detail falls into place. Now the trap works against the Herald of Darkness. Right on cue, bubbling to the surface from untold depths, the horrors come. The emerging monsters do not expect the warm reception that has already been prepared for them.
Saving Emma. as I show up, I guess.
Are you feeling neglected? You shouldn't. You know Eddie Rodman's got love for you, which is why I actually hauled myself out of bed before noon, just so I could record an interview for your pleasure. Enjoy. Now, as I'm sure you all know, the annual Night Springs Visual Arts Show is coming around again, and that's a big deal for all of us that are in the culture business. If you can call it a business, that's a little controversial, I know.
Oh, that's okay. Money makes the world go around, no doubt about it.
And that's one of my guests here in the studio, Serena Valdivia. She's a curator at the Night Springs Gallery of Visual Arts, and she's in charge of the NSVA Film Festival, held this year at the old Night Springs Drive-In Theater.
Hello, Eddie. It's great to be here. And let me just say that it's a wonderful venue.
Absolutely. And with her is one of the filmmakers, somebody who's actually primarily known as a renowned photographer, Alice Wake.
Hello.
Alice, I've seen a lot of your work over the years. It's very impressive. And my wife's a big fan, actually.
Oh, thank you.
You've gained quite a bit of fame as a photographer, but that's not why you're here, right? You actually have a film. That's a little surprising.
For me, too. I really wouldn't be here at all if it weren't for Serena.
You two are friends, I take it?
Yeah, we move in the same circles. So about a year ago, I heard about all this footage she'd shot, and I got to see some of it, and then I started pestering her about actually putting it out there, because it was really good.
I didn't really want to show it. It felt too personal.
Well, yes, I can understand that. It features your husband, and
He's dead.
I thought he was missing.
It's been 2 years. This sounds awful, but yes, I believe he's dead. Otherwise, he would have... Well, you know.
Yeah, I understand. Well, hold that thought, and we'll be right back.
So I've been thinking about Barry. I don't know what to do about him yet. I mean, I'm not gonna keep him around, that's for sure. Al? Al? Ugh, little parasite. Your best friend. Really? That's the best you can do. I actually kinda like the guy.
He's a plucky little butterball.
He plays the clown. That's a hard road to take. But I don't need him sticking his fat face in my business. Did you know he's been hanging out with the sheriff from that shitty little town? They keep in touch. Barry's about the only guy who insists that you're not dead. How about that? I might keep him alive for a while. Just to see him go to pieces when I fire his ass. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, thanks for saving me again. I'd hate to die before I'm scheduled to be murdered.
I guess I have you to thank for setting everything up at the oil derrick.
Yeah, well, I figured that if we were going to go over this again, we might as well try to be smart about it, huh?
I appreciate it. You took a big chance doing that. Are you okay?
What do you think? I've died twice. I remember everything pretty clearly now. You said I was gonna be okay.
I don't know what happened.
Well, it's not your fault. I think one of those, what did you call them? The takers? I think they did something to the power and they got me that way.
I'm sorry.
And I got the keys from the dead guy in that room. And I'm not handing them over until you do something about this. I'm sick of getting killed.
Fair enough. You seem calmer now.
I tried freaking out. Didn't do much good for me. I guess you get used to the craziest stuff.
Good for you.
Plus, I figured I'd take the edge off, you know?
Mm-hmm. Those herbal supplements are pretty good, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I wanted to try to explain things to you now, since you're calmer, but maybe this isn't the best time after all.
Oh, shit, yeah. Better not get all metaphysical on me now. Seriously, I'm like two sentences away from thinking how we could all be like atoms on God's skin or something.
Or figments of somebody's imagination?
Wow. I'm just gonna try to chill out and not think about that or getting murdered or anything, if you're cool with that.
Gotcha. Okay. I really don't think they can get to the power now.
Thank you. That's a relief. Here's the keys that you needed.
Thank you.
Hey, I have to tell you. At the diner, I went there with him. The guy who looks like you, okay? I know I said that I didn't.
Yeah, I figured. Want to talk about what happened at the diner?
There was this guy from the observatory, and he just attacked the poor dude, smashed his face into the tabletop a bunch of times. It was horrible. I didn't know that he was gonna do that. I swear. And I just ran. I just left him there. I didn't even try to help.
There was nothing you could have done. It's not your fault.
Well, he's dead in that motel room now, so excuse me if I feel pretty shitty about it anyway.
You shouldn't blame yourself.
I just didn't want to get involved. I have this tendency to just drop everything and run. I don't think I'm a bad person, but I didn't even call the cops. I'm such a coward.
If you'd called the cops, we'd have dead cops. He's not human. Do you understand? It's not your fault.
But I could have tried to stop him.
Believe me, if you had, you'd be dead. You seem to be doing a little better now.
Yeah, I guess it just got easier once I got this thing off my chest. I just feel so guilty about it, especially because I didn't pick up on any of the warning signs. I just really liked hanging out with him, you know? He was smart and charming and funny and hot. The way you could be, I guess.
I guess.
What's the deal with this guy anyway? He looks like you, he uses your name. Why does he do this stuff?
I'm not sure myself. Maybe he's just evil or my dark half. He does a lot of the stuff I'm trying really hard to get away from. Things that just messed up my life.
I guess all those murders don't help either.
Yeah, I could do without the murders and the end of the world. Listen, I need to get going.
Yeah, go. I think I'm good now, I hope.
Good luck. If it all goes well, maybe this is the last time we meet like this.
God, wouldn't that be great?
Just keep those lights on, okay? Thank you.
The fate of countless individuals hangs in the balance, threatened by the machinations of the Herald of Darkness. And yet, for a moment, the Champion of Light breathes a little easier. He has saved one life. For this moment, it is enough. And soon, perhaps, he can put an end to this.